analysis of given sample of hot water.
EDTA crystals, weight of EDTA plus weight of the weighing bottle W1 I am taking, it is 5.833, it is coming. Now I will be transferring this to funnel with this volumetric flask which is previously filled with distilled water. So then I will be taking the weight of weighing bottle alone, that is W2, that is coming 3.5 grams. So difference of this we need to take.
Known weight of EDTA salt I have taken. Now for this we need to add 1 test tube of ammonium hydroxide. Ammonia solution we need to add it, 1 test tube, in order to dissolve these crystals. Little distilled water is added to run down the crystals which is sticking into the funnel and also to the inner walls of volumetric flask. So afterwards it need to be dissolved with the minimum quantity of added distilled water. Slowly with the constant shaking to ensure that all crystals are dissolved. Like that, I am adding distilled water. Now you can fill this distilled water using this wash bottle up to the stem, and little portion below the mark need to be make up with the help of burette. Here I have added the distilled water using this wash bottle. So then the remaining portion just below this, so that need to be added with the help of burette. Now it is made up to the mark. The lower meniscus should coincide to the line. Now you have to shake it well for uniform concentration by putting this topper. Of this prepared standard solution to rinse the burette. Like this, this needs to be rinsed. It is to be rejected into sink. Now again this burette is to be filled with the prepared standard solution of disodium salt of EDTA. Slowly you have to add above zero, because this nozzle portion is vacant, that need to be filled. Adjust the reading to zero. The lower meniscus should coincide to touch this zero mark on this burette graduation. This is hard water sample. Pipette out 25 ml of hard water sample. So it need to be adjusted to, and it need to be transferred. Then for this, we need to add 1 test tube of ammonia, ammonium chloride buffer. Then 3 to 4 drops of iriochrome black tea indicator. On adding indicator, it will get a wine red color. So now it is to be titrated with standard solution taken in this burette till the color changes from wine red color to clear blue. Slowly you have to add. So whenever it is reaching near to end point, add drop wise slowly. Now just near to end point you need to add slowly. Yes, end point has come. So this is the color, wine red to clear blue. You need to get it. Okay, you need to get it with white background. Just I am showing for ensuring that you are seeing the proper color change. End point that is coming to exactly 10 mL. According to the weight of the salt, depending on the weight of salt, the titer value will change. Whatever you got, that you just write it. This is what final burette reading. So this is initial burette reading, that is 0, 10 mL. And already we have taken the known weight of EDTA by taking W1 and W2. And this is the weight of EDTA. And that need to be multiplied with 4 divided by 372.24. Then how much molarity you are getting, that you have to write it. So now like this, you need to repeat the titration for getting concordant titer values and 10 ml that I have written. And similarly, I got 2 more trials carried out to get concordant titer values. It comes to 10 ml. So next is calculation. So calculation is again 1000 cm cube of 1 molar EDTA is equal to 100 grams of CaCO3. So therefore, 10 ml of 0.02530 normal molar EDTA contains how much? It is multiplied by 100 into 10 into 0.02503 divided by 1000. This 100 is the molecular weight of calcium carbonate. It is expressed in CaCO3 equivalents. So it comes to 0.02503 gram of calcium carbonate. So 25 ml contains this much. Therefore, 10 power 6 cm cube of hard water contains how much? 0.025 into 10 power 6 divided by 25. So if you multiply, it gives 1001 ppm of CaCO3. So this is the total hardness of given sample of hard water.